Hello everyone, Bob Rasooli, Orange County, California. Today I'm here with another short video. This time is about API 570 exam. One of the questions I get from my audience and my API 570 exam prep course students is that how much time they have to put on the ASME B31.3. So one of the major standards that included in the API 570 exam is ASME B31.3, which is very extensive content. So previously it was almost 30%, 40% of the exam questions came from the ASME B31.3, but the trend has changed. Now we have a less focus on the ASME B31.3 and majority of the questions are from API 570 standard. So how much time you have to put on the ASME B31.3 should be limited. Actually, you're gonna get almost 2-3 questions directly from the ASME B31.3, and the rest is gonna be the questions that is from the API 570, but you need to refer to the ASME B31.3 to get some information. What you need to learn about the ASME B31.3, if you wanna cover it in the few hours instead of the few days, is that you need to know what's the A1 table, which is provides you the allowable stress, A1B, which provides you the joint efficiency, longitudinal joint efficiency, and also PWHT post-weld heat treatment table, and also impact testing tables, which is the two table on the impact testing. If you learn these 1, 2, 3, and 4 items, it's gonna be enough actually for your API 570 exam, the knowledge you need from the ASME B31.3. To calculate the minimum required thickness, you need to know what is the allowable stress, and also you need to the joint efficiency. But actually the formula you're gonna use is gonna be API 574, which is a small formula over there. Is almost similar to the ASME B31.3 formula, but this one has a little bit shorter than that formula, and then you're gonna put the plug in the number and calculate minimum required thickness. But to have the allowable stress on that formula, you need to go to the A1 table, and for joint efficiency, A1B table. The direct question can be from the PWHT, which is gonna give you the material. You have to identify what is the P number for that certain material, and then go to the PWHT and find what is the holding time and what is the PWHT temperature. For impact testing, you can get the direct question from the ASME B31.3. One is gonna ask you to see what is this material you can use without performing the impact testing. There's a certain table on the B31.3 that you can go and locate the material and the wall thickness and see what is the minimum design metal temperature that you can use this material without impact testing. And another one is when you are performing the impact testing is the a table that provides you the acceptance criteria for any certain material. So these are the things that you need to learn from the B31.3 that you can cover in few hours instead of the few days, and then move to the API 570, because the API 570, the majority questions is gonna be from the API 570. Please subscribe to our channel. We're having a short video every day, and then you're not gonna lose our videos.